Hey everyone, Don and Ash here.
Hello.
Back for another reaction video. This time we're going to be taking a look at a champion teaser for Taliyah called Homecoming. Taliyah's a hero that we first saw in the call and
yeah.
We both thought she was really cool.
Yeah. I love that. Like, yeah, we've seen her with Kaisa.
Yeah.
And they were on this journey to, I believe, in relation to Taliyah and like her heritage.
We've also seen her in another cinematic where she was like
in the climb.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure it
was going from like sand to ice or sand to snow or something like that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, we're going to check that out. And we're also going to check out a quick teaser that they did for Taliyah in Star Guardian.
Yes.
Yeah, that's called, it's just called Sessions. And we'll check that out right after the teaser. So without further ado, I'm excited. Let's get into it.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, it's a Sphinx head.
Anubis.
She's in Shurima, though. I'm like scared for her safety. I'm like, where's Rek'Sai?
Yeah.
I will follow this path until the end.
Like, you got a ways to go, though?
Yeah. All right. Interesting. I mean, I feel like they do a better job with some of the teasers than others. Like, that didn't really give me any...
anything to, like, go off of?
No, just, it didn't give me any, idea of what the hero is about.
Yeah.
You didn't really see her abilities, but she did say something. I just want to go back and just note on a couple things here. So, like, the use of light was awesome. Let's bring that back in. Yeah, as soon as her face comes in, I thought that was pretty cool. I mean, I guess you get a teaser. She's cruising on something. But honestly, if you don't know that, it's just like that she like shapeshifts rocks or whatever.
Yeah.
I honestly think it's like a Silver Surfer like hoverboard or something. But no, I like the scene where she comes in here
And
the lights on her face. And it's just like the coloring is just really nice.
Yeah.
And then,
it immediately just adds so much warmth and life to the scene.
Especially how it's coming in from the bottom right? Like,
yeah.
It doesn't come in, like, layering. Like, it just comes in smooth.
Yes.
It comes in quite smooth,
yeah.
And it's just, yeah. So she says...
The stories were true.
Yeah, we talked over that part. Our mistake. But, Yeah, no idea what that symbol is. You guys will have to let us know what that symbol is or what that means as far as, like, Shurima goes. We do plan to watch other cinematics featuring other heroes that have to do with Shurima as well relatively soon. So I can't wait to find out more about this entire region because, like, honestly, it's the one region across all the franchises that we don't know much about
yet. I was going to say, yeah, it's still kind of shrouded in mystery for us.
Yeah. So yeah, I can't wait to learn about that region, and honestly, all the heroes that come from that region, all the heroes inspired by that region.
Yeah, I just want to appreciate, like, again, the art style here of her face close up. It has more of those, like, actual, like, line work to it that you get to see, which reminds me a lot more of a comic book style.
You know what I like about line work like this, like, on her nose as you bring it up, is that, like, sometimes in animated TV shows, when they choose to do this style, and, like, the character's face is, like, here, but then say, like, they move their face here, the line that is the prominent line that creates the edge, like, will move.
Yes.
Right? Like,
yeah.
Like they'll change the line that moves, I guess because it's a different drawing and frames and whatever, but I always think that's, like, super cool. That's such a small little detail.
Yeah.
Or even, like, the little, very slim little highlight line where it should be, right?
Yeah, exactly. I just wanted to note it because I feel like it's not something that we see on the regular from them.
Yeah.
So it's just nice to see.
Yeah. No, absolutely.
Yeah. Did a great job illustrating it.
Yeah, you see her ride the rocks for like 3 seconds there.
Yeah.
Awesome. I wonder what she's headed towards, though. I'd love to find out.
Like, we know it's home, but, like, we want to know more about home.
100%.
Yeah.
All right, let's quickly jump into the other one, which is the Star Guardian Sessions teaser. So this looks completely different. We get to see her in a little bit of a different light. Honestly... let's just get into this.
Yeah, I'm excited.
All right, let's do it. Oh, it's Fiddlesticks. Yeah, that reminds me of his his outfit we saw. The
yeah,
birthday
I
one,
remember, yeah.
I feel like that's what that is.
It is.
It is Fiddlesticks, yeah. He also reminds me of the, that one boss that, the, whatever legion from, the game we just quit. What is that bloody game?
Oh,
Lost Ark. You know,
yeah,
you know
yeah.
The Mayhem Legion. If anybody plays Lost Ark and you know the boss of the Mayhem Legion, literally, that's what he looks like. Let's just
yeah.
go back. I'm spot on with my analogies.
Always.
I know it. I know
always.
It's him 100%. But like, there's also a comic book character, or not a comic book character. It's another animated show that he reminds me of. I cannot think about it. Is it Alistair?
Yeah, I was gonna say you. I knew.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I knew you're that was my first thought, but then you said the guy from Lost Ark. But that was my first thought was Alistair.
Can we like just watching this like so much Sailor Moon, like the style down to the T.
Yeah.
The line work, just you know.
I love the song. I'm like.
Yeah, yeah. The hair, like, just everything. I love how he comes out from the corner and he's got like what looks like a Sailor Moon type. You know,
so, yeah.
Scythe or whatever. It's just like inspired by like, I love how it has the horse.
The horse, the knight. The,
yeah,
no,
was,
yeah.
Yeah,
knight, knight.
I'm
yeah.
like, we are not chess players, clearly. She's like, huh?
Yeah.
Hi.
I love that also like he's by his display. So there's like cookies of him
yeah,
and
yeah.
a little like figurine.
Yeah, just going back here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's hilarious. That is so funny. I want a Fiddlesticks figurine. Not a plushie this time. I want like a figurine. One of those ones that has like hinges in the knees and in the elbows so I can put
oh,
them into
yeah,
different,
yeah, yeah.
different
that
positions.
That would be so cool.
Yeah.
I agree.
Level
up.
Yeah. Oh, we said at the same time. Level up. Level up. Level up. Level up.
Yeah.
Lucky zone. Just seeing if there's any like...
any little Easter eggs.
Yeah. That's the word I was looking for. Game changer. Hot stuff. Hot something. I love how she's a skater. I'm like,
yeah.
if she's a skater in this show, I'm like, I
Which
honestly,
like...
I grew up like 16 years before I like quit, before I stopped of skateboarding. I grew up a skater and I'm like, she might be like, I think you're looking more forward to the show than I am, but I'm like,
yeah.
that might be a character I can attach to. Yay!
Well, the thing is, so Star Guardian isn't a show though.
Well, it should be.
It should be, I agree. But yeah, it's not a show.
An animated series.
It should be. It's more so like their comics online, I think. If I remember someone commented in our previous video about it that I think it's more stories online and then like they have these little trailers. Like there's a couple of them, but yeah, it's not a full story and it would be awesome if it was a full animated story.
Make the damn story. Why Rito Dorito, what you doing, man?
It was really cool. And actually I think because as soon as you mentioned skateboard actually I think it actually ties in really well with her overall character because she can, like, ride
right,
the rocks. And,
right.
you know, it kind of works with her flow of things.
Duh.
Yeah, and I didn't put that together until
no.
you said skateboard. And I was like, well,
I didn't put it
actually.
Together until you just said that. I'm like, yeah, I was not even thinking that.
Yeah, I think that suits her really well. That was a good tie-in for sure. We've only seen the one other video for Star Guardian, so we don't know anything else. But I think it's cool that they've added her into it.
Or at least, well, this came out only 6 months ago, so this could be like a teaser.
Is a,
it says the title says Star Guardian Taliyah coming soon, so
yeah.
who knows what they're going to do with that. But honestly, I remember watching Sailor Moon as a kid just because it was like the show right before Pokemon or the show right before Dragon Ball Z or something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, yeah.
They were all together. So honestly, like, you know, even if you didn't want to keep up on Sailor Moon, you know, as a little dude, you kept up on it anyway because it was like, it was right there.
It was right there, yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, I definitely have some catching up too. Like, I look forward to learning more about the Star Guardian universe. And I, like I said, I know there's like the online comics to read, so I got some reading to do.
I'm so bad at checking out the online comics, not even just for this show, but like for
in
all,
general.
Yeah, just all their stuff. Like,
yeah.
whatever.
There's so much there, and then it's like, it's hard to even remember that that also exists on top of everything else they do.
Yeah, yeah, no, absolutely. But that was awesome. I think that was awesome. Like, honestly,
yeah.
a 10 out of 10 teaser for 30 seconds, I really, really enjoyed that.
Yeah, I agree. Me too.
Well, I think that wraps it up.
Yes.
As always, please let us know your favorite moments in the comments down below, mm-hmm. and maybe little factoids that... don't ruin the universe of Star Guardian.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyways, as always, please like, share, and especially subscribe. And we will see you in the next one. All right.
Bye.